Hello and welcome to Genius Yield's second monthly update. Here at Genius Yield, we've had an incredibly busy and productive month, and we've also made a number of exciting announcements that I will be summarizing for you today. Also, we have something very special to show you today. We will give you a first look at our Genius Dex UI that's been deployed on the testnet. Last, our CTO will give us a demo on how to place a limit order, and we will see it being processed by our smart order routers. Let's start with our ISPO update. Our ISPO has been incredibly successful so far, with all our stake pools almost full to saturation, except for our pool Gens 2, which is getting close to saturation. Just a reminder, current Cardano saturation is around 68 million ADA. In total, we have over 273 million ADA staked. We have close to 12,000 delegators, and we have rewarded close to 5 million GENS tokens to our delegators. That represents about 50% of the supply for the ISPO. So thank you everyone for making this ISPO so successful and for your continuous support. We hope to continue to earn your delegation. Just as a side note, Gens 4 has been shut down on February 19th. So if you are still staking on Gens 4, please unstake. You will no longer be generating Gens rewards with this pool. Next up, we have our Genius Yield white paper. So in January, we've released our highly anticipated white paper that outlines the design of our DEX. It is a next generation DEX based on an order book design combined with an AI powered yield optimizer. This month, we've decided to provide you with a summary of that white paper to give you a more condensed article on all the best highlights of the white paper in a smaller format. This paper outlines how our design is really taking has been really built from the ground up to take advantage of the unique benefits provided by Cardano UTXO's smart contract paradigm. And by doing so, this allows us to provide functionalities that are difficult to replicate in an AMM design. These functionalities are smart swaps, concentrated liquidity, a highly parallelizable design, as well as a highly decentralized protocol, and smart liquidity vaults. So this white paper summary has been really well received. If you haven't read it already, then a link to it will be provided in the description below. Next, we have GeniusX. So this month we've released our GeniusX website, and you can find it at genius-x.co. As a reminder, GeniusX is our accelerator program that helps entrepreneurs and founders build their startups on Cardano. We provide support such as fundraising, ISPO design, as well as legal and regulatory consulting, and also support on the engineering and smart contract design. So far, we already have seven startups that have been accepted into the program. These are Martify, Maestro, Carda Hub, Smart Places Protocol, Igon, and Cardano Feed. So if you want to check out those promising startups, please check out our website for more details. And if yourself are building on Cardano and would like to join the Accelerator program, then we also have an application form that you can find on our website. The goal here is to really support the entire Cardano community, right? We are still, as a blockchain, very young, and we have a lot of work to build out our DeFi ecosystem. And so the goal is, by helping other projects become successful, we are helping the Cardano blockchain in general to grow and be successful. Next up, we have our partnerships. This month, we've announced two amazing partnerships that I'm very excited to talk to you about today. The first one is a partnership with Twig, which is a leader an expert in smart contract auditing, and Haskell and Plutus Engineering Consulting. They will be providing their auditing services to all of GeniusX products and smart contract, but as well to all our partners at GeniusX. So this will provide projects part of the Accelerator program access to high quality auditing for their own smart contracts. The second partnership is with Grant Thornton, one of the largest business advisory firm in the world, actually. And so we're very excited to be able to partner with such an industry leader, and they will be providing us with legal, regulatory, tax, and accounting services to really grow and support the GeniusX platform. And these services will also be available to our GeniusX startups. So with those two partnerships announced, this makes actually our GeniusX Accelerator program very compelling, where building Cardano has never been easier, where those programs can really help you grow your business and be successful. Next, we are announcing also a mascot contest. So GeniusYield is organizing a community-driven contest to find our new official mascot. So we are calling for all artists and creators to design and submit their designs for our mascots. The mascot will be used throughout our GeniusYield platform, as well as it will be turned into an NFT collection that will be that with the help of one of our GeniusX partner, Martify and CardaHub. The winner will receive a special prize of 5,000 gens, as well as a percentage of the sales made and the royalties from the NFT sales. So if you are interested in participating and helping us create our new GeniusYield mascot, please check out more information in the description below. We've also launched our ambassador program this month. This program is a way for influencers and community members to help grow the GeniusYield branding and increase our outreach into our community. In exchange, ambassadors will earn a monthly GENS reward. So if you're interested in becoming an ambassador for GeniusYield, or you want to learn more about the responsibility of an ambassador, please check out our ambassador page on our main website. And lastly, we had a couple of YouTube interviews this month. The first one with Lars, our CTO, and Bart, our marketing managers, that were interviewed in the Learn Cardano YouTube channel. And then more recently, I've been interviewed by BigPay, and that video will be released shortly. So if you want to learn more about GeniusYield and get more details on our DEX and our Yield Optimizer, please check out those videos. They will be linked in the description below.
Hello, everyone. In the last month, we have made quite a lot of progress, but a lot of that is not really visible to the end user because we made a lot of improvements on our infrastructure. So for example, we set up a private testnet, which will allow us to test quicker and more reliably. And we started containerizing our environment so that we can run our server in a container and have a development environment that is the same for every developer in a container and things like that. Also improved logging, error reporting. And these things are very important both for the reliability of the application as well as for development and testing. But of course, they are not very visible to the user. However, one thing that's very nice and that is indeed visible is we have our first integration of the UI with the backend, with the server. So it's now possible to use the GeniusYield UI to create orders, cancel orders, and in combination with a simple version of our bot that can pair up orders, you can even see those orders being filled if they happen to fit. Later, of course, there will be liquidity pools and the bots will make use of those. So then everything is much more flexible and virtually every order will be filled if there is a appropriate pool. But for the time being, it's very simple. So we're only looking for matching orders. And then if we find any, we can pair them up and fill them. It's more of a proof of concept to show that the integration of the UI with the server works. And I would like to demonstrate a simple example of this now. So in this example, I've connected the wallet to our UI. So we can actually check it. So I'm using Nami Wallet. And in particular, let's look at these two native tokens, TGen and TADA. So they have nothing to do with the real Gens token and real ADA. They are just example tokens for us with suggestive names. So we see that this user here has 100 Gens and 50 ADA. And let's say he wants to sell some of his Gens. So for example, offer 10 Gens in exchange for 20 ADA. So here we see this pair, Gens ADA, and we see 50 ADA is available, but I switch now the direction. So I have 100 Gens, and I said I want to sell them for 20 ADA, and the price, let's say, is 0.5. So if I do that, then I see here that's exactly what I said, what I wanted to do. So I'm buying 20 ADA and pay 10 Gens. So actually, it's like logically what I do is I offer 10 Gens and the price will be 20 ADA. So I can place this order by pushing buy. I get a summary again and can confirm. Now the Nami wallet plugin pops up and asks me to sign, and I can also inspect this here. So I see there is 0.2 ADA fees. These higher figures here, the 3.7 ADA, comes from the requirement of having minimum deposits. So that I would get back if I cancel the order. And I also see here minus one assets. So that's the 10 Gens token that I'm placing in the order. So that looks okay. So I can sign, entering my password, confirming. And we see the order appearing in our order book. Let me place another one. Let's say where I ask for 30 ADA. So I'm offering 15 Gens. Again, I have to confirm. Let's check. Yes, 15 Gens looks good. So I sign. Cardano works with a slot length of 1 second, and there is one block on average every 20 slots, so every 20 seconds. But it's just on average. So sometimes blocks can follow each other quite quickly, other times there's a minute or so in between them. So it's unpredictable how long it will take until the order actually ends up on the blockchain. But here we now see our second order. So now let me switch to a different Nami wallet. Obviously, in reality, this would be a different user on a different machine, maybe at the other end of the world. But for this demo, I just switch to another wallet in Nami. And if we check here, this user only has 50 TADA and no Gens. So let me refresh the UI here. And let's say I now want to buy 10 Gens. So I have my 50 ADA, I want to buy 10 Gens. Let's say I use the same price, so 2 ADA per Gens. So this would now exactly match the order we created earlier. So let's place it. Get the pop-up from Nami Wallet. In this case, we are sending ADA because we want to buy Gens, so that looks okay. We sign that as well. and we see the order appearing in the order book. Now what will happen is that the bots running on the server side will permanently scan the blockchain for orders and try to find matching pairs of orders or also triples. And if they do find such a pair, then they will fill it. So they will fill the one order with the other. So in our case, because I picked the example accordingly, we have these two orders that perfectly match, and the bot should pick them up and fill them. So this user should end up with 10 gens in exchange for 20 ADA that go to the first user. And the order has disappeared from the order book. So let me check my wallet. And indeed, instead of formerly 50 TADA, we now only have 30, but we have 10 TGen. So this worked. The user successfully bought 10 TGen. Let me switch back to the other user. Let me refresh the UI. So the one order is still here. Let me demonstrate that canceling an order also works. So I cancel this one. And we see now we get one asset back, the gens that were locked in this order. And we also see we get a bunch of ADA back. That's what I said earlier, that most of the ADA we had to pay were not transaction fees, but just used for deposits. And if they're not needed any longer, you get them back. However, these transaction fees and the deposits will also change when we actually launch on mainnet. So right now, it's just more or less arbitrary numbers that we pick to get anything working quickly. So we will, of course, try to minimize the costs and the deposits necessary to make using our platform as cheap as possible. And the order disappeared. Let me check the wallet. So let's see, we have 90 of the 100 TGen left. So the 10 missing ones are the order that was filled by the bot that now went to the other user. And we have 70 TADA. So we started with 50, and now we have 70 because the other user paid 20 in exchange for these 10. So I've demonstrated how the UI interacts with our backend, is integrated with the backend, and you can place orders and you can cancel orders, and the bot in the background tries to match orders and fill them. So now, next month, we will also have the UI for our liquidity pools ready, and we already have bots for that. So on the backend, that all works already. Even though, of course, we are still optimizing the bots and making them smarter and allowing them to process more orders in bulk to increase the throughput and be more intelligent about it. But nevertheless, we have some simple bots that are working. So next month, we will be able to demonstrate all of this in combination with liquidity pools.
That's it for today. So thank you very much for joining me. As you can see, we've had a very exciting month here at Junior Sealed. We are growing very fast, but this is just the beginning. We have a lot of future announcements to make that we can't wait to let you know. Thank you again for your support, and I will see you in the next technical update. Bye.